Distinguished future physicians, welcome to Stomp on Step 1, the only free video series that helps you study more efficiently by focusing on the highest yield material. I'm Brian McDaniel, and I will be your guide on this journey through vulvovaginal infections. This is the third video in my playlist covering all of microbiome. Vulvovaginitis, aka vaginitis, is inflammation of the lower genital tract. It is usually due to infection, but there is a wide variety of causes. During this video, we will focus on the three most important causes of vulvovaginitis for the medical board exam: Trichomonas, Candida, and BV. However, you should know that other types of vaginitis include mechanical irritation, allergic reaction to soap or feminine products, and a variety of other infections. Atrophic vaginitis is a common cause of vaginitis in postmenopausal women, and we will cover that in a later video in the GYN section. Gonorrhea and chlamydia present primarily with cervicitis, but it can also cause vulvovaginitis. GC will be covered later in its own video. We will start with a few different tests that we will use to differentiate between the different infections. Wet prep, aka wet mount test, is a microscopic examination of vaginal discharge used to differentiate between different types of vulvovaginitis. The vaginal specimen is obtained using a speculum and a Q-tip, similar to how one gets a pap smear. Then the specimen is rubbed onto a glass slide. One half of the slide has a drop of saline added to it, while the other half of the slide has a drop of 10 to 20% KOH, potassium hydroxide, added to it. When saline is added, it makes it easier to view clue cells for BV and flagellated motile cells for Trichomonas. The KOH kills bacteria and vaginal cells, leaving only yeast cells. This makes it easier to view the pseudohyphae and budding yeast present during vulvovaginal candidiasis. KOH is also alkalotic, so it can be used for a Whiff test. In this scenario, when the alkalotic KOH is added to a sample containing BV, it will create an amine or fishy smell. This is a similar principle behind how the smell of BV can increase after unprotected sex, since semen is alkalotic. The normal vaginal pH for a reproductive age woman is about 4, while the normal vaginal pH before puberty and after menopause is about 7. During puberty, there is an estrogen-guided increase in the growth of lactobacilli flora. These bacteria break down glycogen into lactic acid, which lowers pH from about 7 to 4. Now that you know the normal values, you can apply it to the diseases. Usually bacterial vaginosis and Trichomonas have alkalotic pH, greater than 4.5 in reproductive age women, while Candida has normal pH less than 4.5. pH can be tested using pH paper on vaginal discharge. You can see here at the top right corner that I give BV a high yield rating of 3 on a scale from 1 to 10. If you want to learn more about this rating system, you can go to my website or click on this orange box here if you're watching the video on a computer. Bacterial vaginosis, aka BV, is a polymicrobial infection caused by the overgrowth of normal flora. The key bacteria in this infection is gram-negative gardnerella vaginalis. Clue cells are visible on the saline portion of a wet prep. A clue cell is a soft mucosal squamous epithelial cell covered in many adherent coccoid bacteria, gardnerella vaginalis. Here's a picture comparing normal squamous epithelial cells with a few scattered lactobacilli to squamous cells that are covered in thousands of adherent gardnerella bacteria. Here's one more pic. You can see on the left we have the normal squamous epithelial cell with a few white blood cells. On the right we have the darker clue cell. Finally, I have a photomicrograph to look at in case you see that on your test. A thin, watery gray discharge is present in BV. A foul smell is present and often described as an amine odor or fishy smell. This smell is intensified after unprotected intercourse or when KOH is added, aka positive whiff test. There is an alkalotic pH greater than 4.5 in reproductive age women. There's minimal itching and minimal inflammation or erythema present, with few leukocytes visible in microscopy. Treatment includes topical metronidazole or oral metronidazole if that doesn't work. Clindamycin is another option. If you have been following along with the microbiome section, you will know that I already have a video on fungi in Canada. I'm not going to go over the same material here, but I will cover some information that is specific to vaginal candidiasis. Vulvovaginal candidiasis, aka yeast infection, is an overgrowth of ubiquitous fungi. The most common subtype of candida infections in the vaginal tract is albicans, but you can also see glabrata and tropicalis, especially if it is resistant to treatment. Yeast infections mostly happen in patients with altered flora, including the immunosuppressed, people who recently took antibiotic therapy, or are on corticosteroids. It can also happen in individuals with increased glycogen, including diabetics, pregnant individuals, and women on oral contraceptives. Keeping the vagina warm with tight-fitting clothing, like a bathing suit, also is a risk factor. Severe inflammation leads to bright red erythema, vulvar pruritus, severe itching, burning, dysuria, painful urination, and dyspareunia, painful intercourse. There is a lumpy or thick, adherent, white cottage cheese-like discharge present. Yeast infections are odorless, and vulvovaginal candidiasis has a normal pH. You can see here an example of the budding yeast and pseudohyphae seen on the KOH portion of a wet prep. Treatment is over-the-counter topical miconazole monostat, oral fluconazole diflucan, or topical terconazole terazole. Trichomoniasis, aka Trichomonas vaginalis, is a very contagious STD. Therefore, the question sum will almost always mention unprotected sexual activity. Inflammation leads to burning, itching, erythema, dysuria, and dyspareunia. Many leukocytes are seen on microscopic examination. Patchy erythema on the cervix is referred to as strawberry petechiae. Note that this finding can be easily confused with cervicitis, gonorrhea, and chlamydia. There is a thin, watery, frothy, or bubbly yellow-green discharge present. On saline prep, you see motile or moving flagellated protozoa. You may have malodorous, fishy, or foul smell. There is usually an alkalotic pH greater than 4.5 in reproductive age. The treatment is oral metronidazole for both partners to prevent reinfection. So it is the same treatment as BV, which makes things a little bit easier to remember. To review, here are some buzzwords that should stand out to you in question stems. If you just know the info on this slide, you can probably get most of these questions right. Trich is the only one of the three that is an STD and motile under a microscope. A strawberry cervix is also only present in Trich when talking about these three different diseases, although other diseases can cause cervical inflammation. Candida has budding yeast and pseudohyphae, as well as a normal pH, which makes it unique. BV has clue cells and minimal itching, which helps differentiate it from the other two. Thank you to Clark Johnson from New York whose generous donation helped bring this video to you all. If you'd like to help out, you can donate on our website or help spread the word via telling your classmates or even posting on social media sites like Facebook. That would really help us out. If you would like to be taken directly to the next video in our microbio section, you can click on this black box here. That video will start us off with our virus videos, and it will be about the many different types of herpes, including CMV, EBV, like mono type symptoms, the STD versions of herpes, and chickenpox and shingles. Thank you so much for watching, and good luck with the rest of your studying.